Penguin Random House presents Small Acts of Freedom by Gurmehar Kaur. Read by Arpita Vohra. Introduction. In February 2017, a few friends asked me if I wanted to join them for a protest at Ramjas College. I said no. I did not know the details of the protest. I wish I had known then what I know now. That they were protesting against campus violence. That all they wanted was the right to conduct a seminar on cultures of protest. Little did I know how important peace activism and protest culture would turn out to be for me in the months to come. At the time, as a student of Lady Shri Ram College, I had only heard bits and pieces here and there, read a few social media updates and seen a few articles. I had attended a few events in the past within the Delhi University activism circuit, so it didn't come as a surprise that they expected me to go. I had been very vocal in college, always striking up political conversations and debate. But that day, I had a lot on my mind. Earlier in February, I had had a falling out with a few friends I deeply cared about and loved. I was still nursing the wounds and dealing with the emotional drama that came along with it. All of this was during the final month of the semester, when we were supposed to submit our assignments. I was studying English and I loved my course, so I buried myself under reading assignments and worked to avoid thinking about my personal dilemmas. Why am I telling you about my personal dilemmas and my arguments with friends? It is because I want you to know that I was living an ordinary life, a teenager's life. My head was full of gossip and clothes and trends and books and other things you might expect me to be occupied with. I don't feel like that girl anymore. Today, I think about censorship and freedom of expression. I think about liberalism and online abuse. I think about the state of our nation far more frequently than I ever did in those days. With my exams coming, the Ramjas College Fest was the last thing on my mind. In fact, after a rough time at our own fest that year, I wanted to run away as far as I could from the very word itself. I had my own problems. Ramjas can sort out its freedom of expression issue on its own, I thought, and left to get a coffee. My best friend joined me, and we sat to do our work. Every so often, we'd chatter about college gossip. Who was doing what, who was standing for what post on the students' union, whom should we vote for, and if the previous union was corrupt or not. Our phones were on airplane mode because both of us knew that there was no way we could manage to finish our work if there were Instagram and Facebook notifications begging us to glance at our phones. That evening, when we got back to our rooms and turned off the airplane mode, our phones started buzzing with WhatsApp messages. What was going on? Why was everyone panicking? My phone was flooded with harrowing pictures of violence. These were not pictures that were being circulated by the media, who tended to blow things out of proportion anyway, but those that were being sent to us in real time by our own friends who were there. It all happened in a blur. The students who had been peacefully protesting to condemn the campus violence involving the Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad, ABVP, were roughed up. There were long messages telling us what had happened and asking if any of us could shelter the injured girls. But as is the case with most college hostels, no one could enter ours after a certain hour. I was told that students were lathi charged at the protest and shoved into police vans. Then they were taken to a metro station and left there. A series of emotions ran through me. I felt anger, closely followed by helplessness. What could I have done, sitting in my hostel with a curfew of 8:30 p.m.? How could I help when I could not even go out? I kept wondering. This wasn't just breaking news on TV. These were injustices happening to my own friends. It is so easy to dismiss the bad in the world when it is playing on your TV screen like a movie. You start to think it's all fiction, but it never is. It is happening somewhere in the world, to real people, and this time it was happening to the people I knew, people I saw in my college every day, laughing and smiling. How does one resist? I took a piece of paper, one side of which, in fact, had notes from the previous semester, and two different colored pens, red and black. My friend wrote down the message we had just sat together and framed. I stood with my back to the white wooden door, holding up the sheet as my friend clicked a picture. It was uploaded with a caption on my Facebook profile page. This is what the placard said. I am a student from Delhi University. I am not afraid of ABVP. I am not alone. Every student of India is with me. Hashtag students against ABVP. So what really happened at Ramjas? The truth is, after the picture was uploaded, no one cared to find out. All of a sudden, I became the focus of a conversation I had not even started. No one could have predicted the events that followed. I became colored by the narratives people imposed on me. I was the girl with the placard, but I was also the anti-national, the martyr's daughter, the student activist. It was an easier conversation to have than the one that was actually at hand. It was comfortable to overlook the tamasha of rape, death threats and nationalism and focus on a college girl and her Facebook profile pictures instead. They, the people who had suddenly become furious with me, didn't care about what the placard said. They cared about who held it. Students from one of the top colleges in India were pelted with stones, hurt, manhandled. Women were groped, teased and sent anonymous threats. But I understand why the nation wasn't having this conversation. It was too difficult. We would rather shut our eyes than be witness to this violence. It helps us sleep in peace. I am not someone who always speaks up about everything. I am guilty of it too, and I sleep in peace. Even as I write this, there is so much going on in the world that I haven't spoken about. It seems futile sometimes, just talking, just saying something. But that day, after hearing about my friends being manhandled, silence didn't seem like an option. I could not have walked into my college and looked my friends in the eye. I knew I wouldn't be able to. I had lucked out when I said no to them that afternoon. I had escaped the violence, and now, guilt was creeping up on me. What happened at Ramjas College? My friend who was present there told me her story. She doesn't want to be named, and understandably so. Who would want to go through what I had for the mere act of speaking up? On February 21st, 2017, a literary event organized by the English Department and the Literary Society of Ramjas College was disrupted by the members of ABVP. It was meant to be a series of panel discussions on cultures of protest, featuring speakers such as Umar Khalid and Sehla Rashid of Jawaharlal Nehru University and other prominent speakers like Sanjay Kag and Dilip Simon. According to my friend, all the society members had reached the Ramjas campus by 9 that morning. After setting up the registration desk and putting up the posters, they went to the conference hall to attend the first panel discussion. After the first panel, around 11:30 a.m., they heard from someone that a mob was outside the main gate. Almost 1 hour before Umar Khalid's talk, the society members were notified that the principal had cancelled his invitation and a few professors were already in his office. This was odd, since they had already been told that the principal was okay with Khalid coming to the college for the festival. The itinerary had been out for 4 or 5 days. There had been no prior objections. Khalid was meant to speak about the Adivasis in Bastar, and several students from various colleges had come for this discussion. When the society members spoke to the college president and the ABVP intellectual cell head, they were told that as the police wouldn't be able to offer security on campus, Umar Khalid's and Zahla Rashid's invitations had been cancelled. As soon as the announcement was made, some of the visitors on the campus started hooting and sloganeering Bharat Mata Ki Jai. By the time all this commotion was over, the second panel discussion had ended. The organizers went to the conference room. They addressed the crowd and explained why the invitations of the two JNU students were cancelled. Those attending the seminar decided to do a protest walk against the ABVP, the students' union members and the Delhi police. Over 100 people started walking from the conference hall to the principal's office, to the library lawns and back to the conference hall. When they reached the canteen, they were confronted by a mob who began to abuse them and push them aggressively. The Delhi police had created a wall between the disruptors and the students. The police were successful in taking a few people inside the conference room, but had locked them inside. Others could not go inside because the conference room was locked and they couldn't go downstairs because the ABVP supporters had become very violent. Everyone was scared. The students locked inside had to break open the lock so that those who were left behind could enter. Once everyone was inside, they decided to resume their third panel discussion without Umar Khalid. The mob and their supporters downstairs started playing music and dancing at the amphitheatre. The organisers closed all the windows and continued the seminar. According to S. Santosh Kumar Singh, a student of Ramjas College, they were determined to hurt us.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.